it's Friday, and that means it's time for our weekly STEMbassadors segment. This is our chance to highlight women and girls doing great things in STEM. And I'm very excited to have Brenda Glasure with me this week. Took a little convincing to get her here. But let me just give you a little bit of a backstory on how I met Brenda. A year plus ago, I was at Cleveland Flea, and I turned my head, and something caught my eye, and I literally walked clear across the parking lot, picked it up, and said, I want it. And it's this necklace that I'm wearing today. And Brenda does phenomenal jewelry, all handmade. And I needed some repairs done to add a couple extra inches to the necklace. And I went to your house where you repaired it for me. And I got to watch you do your work. And I thought, this is incredible. There's so much more that goes into this than just threading beads and all that kind
there
of
is.
Stuff.
There
so
is.
So how did you get started in this?
Actually, I did start with beads. Mm-hmm. I started with acrylic clay, which people call Sculpey.
Okay.
And I made, I worked in cane work and things like that and created individual beads. And then I got hungry for more. Mm-hmm. So I've just been adding skills and I'll imagine something. And in order to build that, I need a new skill. So
right.
I would learn something new. And just keep adding and adding, and over the years, I've gotten to this place.
So was it hard to make the jump to working with metals?
There are some real key things you have to do. You definitely have to learn how to safely work with soldering, which mm-hmm. means a torch setup, so you have oxygen and propane that you're using. Mm-hmm. You have to learn about a lot about what metals are made of, what's the melting point, so there is metallurgy involved mm-hmm. with this. You know, silver melts at something around 1600 degrees.
Oh my
So you're working with some pretty high degrees.
This isn't novice level kind of stuff that you do.
It's really good to find a mentor when you get to that point. So someone who can show you the ropes.
Well, you showed me the first tool that you use when you start a new project. You want to hold that up for me?
Yes. Well, first I draw.
It's a plastic ruler.
First I draw a picture on some rough picture. I'm not a great artist as far as visual art goes.
Right.
And then I pick up my trusty little plastic ruler and I start measuring. Everything is handmade, so I don't buy components. So if I want to make a flower, I take a piece of silver like this.
That's the silver.
And this is a little sheet of silver. Uh-huh. And this is masking tape, and I just basically draw my flower in there. And then I pick up my jeweler's saw.
Oh, neat.
And I saw the
cut out.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And there is some physics involved with that. You have to have it at the right angle. You have to, you know, it matters how it cuts. And also I would use wire as well. So this is a, you know, there's gauges of wire. Some of it's heavier, some of it's finer. And you use different ones for different projects.
It's just so cool. And I love the way you kind of take an idea and then you just, bam, spit it out. And the one thing that you told me that I loved is that it doesn't always turn out the way you think it's going to.
No, it doesn't.
And you can see the variety and how many different pieces. There's some pieces that have gems in them, and there's some that are just made out of the metals, mixed metals. It's just, the sky's the limit. And I think it's a really cool way for girls to get involved in some other STEM projects without even thinking it's a STEM project.
That's true.
But it certainly is.
The arts really do require, you need the math.
Mm-hmm.
You need some science understanding. I mean, if I didn't have an understanding for the difference in temperatures for what my solder melts at and what my metal melts at, I'd end up with a big puddle of silver, you know?
Well, not only that, but she cooks the books, too, because she has her own little business. It's called Tread the Terra Jewelry, and you can find it at treadtheterrajewelry.com, on Facebook, on Instagram. You could probably find her on my Instagram, because people always ask me about this necklace when I wear it. So, Brenda, thank you for being our STEMbassador this week.
Thank you for
having
me.
I'll be back to do some shopping in just a little.